and Daddy love me. Grandpa and Granny love me. I love my brother, he loves me. I love my sister, she loves me. Mommy and Daddy, Grandpa and Granny, brother, sister, and me. Together we make a family, a happy, happy family. A happy, happy family. A happy, happy family. All right, welcome students to our classroom. I'm going to talk about English subject of your grade 3 English book. And we have already started a lesson about my family, me and my family. And now this is the second lesson. You can open your book on page number 8. And we are going to do some exercises from there. I have already, sang a song from your book. You can remember the tune of we have already sung song together, right? Okay, now we have talked about family, right? Do you remember the members of your family now? Okay, we have also made family tree and we have discussed about different relationships like grandfather, grandmother, mother, father, aunt, and brother and sisters, right? Now we are going to just remember those things and then we are going to do exercise today. Okay, students? Okay, please get ready with your books and copies and pencil with you and be comfortable while we are learning, okay? Let's start. Okay, here we talked about different family members. This is a big family and we have grandfather, grandmother, and uncle, and sister, and brothers and sisters, right? Okay, let's again see what were those people in your family. So family is made up of grandfather, grandmother, father, mother, uncle, aunt, brothers, and sister. And you can see there names like this here. Okay, uncle, you can read it together. Sisters, okay. All right, this is the whole picture of your family. Okay, now I can show you here. I'm going to describe you how it looks in a tree. Once again, we have already made a family tree. Do you remember that? Okay, let's look at this. Okay, let me make you a big picture of a tree. This is a tree. And you have tree trunk here. Okay. Okay. So, at the top of your tree, there are grandfather and grandmother, and then your mother, your father, uncle, aunt, brother, sister. Here also you can have brother and sisters. So likewise, you can make your family tree. Or you can, if you have your bigger family, you can also talk about the another grandfather and grandmother. Do you remember who are they? Okay, let me show you here. There are another grandfather and grandmother as well in your family. Who are they? The father of your mother, right? Here, again, grandfather. Again, we have grandfather and grandmother. How is it so? Because our mother also has father and mother, right? Okay, let me put here. You can write here, grandmother. So, you have grandfather and grandmother from your mother's side, and grandfather and grandmother from your father's side. So, now you are following the father's side, and you have uncle, the son of your, grandfather, another son, brother of your father. And then you have your brothers and sister from the same mother and father. This is how you can make a family tree. We have talked about our family members and we have made our family tree and we have talked about how our family members or a family whole structure looks like. Now, I would like you to describe your family members. Okay, how can you describe your family members? There are certain words to describe people. Okay, so there are describing words in English. Okay, like names of your family members. There are another different words that helps you to describe your family members. For example, you can see here in this picture. Okay, can you see this picture? Yes, there are different words to describe. You can read if you like some of them. Maybe you can understand calm, okay, thirsty, naughty, horrible, moody, handsome, bored, confused. These are some describing words in English. You can use these words to describe. Let me how to describe or how to understand these words. There are certain words, okay, we can use. For example, if you are feeling something, you can describe your feeling as well. So how, what are those feeling words? Okay, let me show you some examples of feeling words and appearance words and personality words. Okay, so you can use these words to describe people, okay, like your family members. Now, bored. This word describes when you have nothing to do and when you feel not very interested, not very happy. Bored means you have no entertainment. When you have no internet in your mobile, you may feel bored. When you have no TV program, good program in your TV, you feel bored. When nobody comes to your house to play with you, you feel bored, right? Then you can say, oh, I feel bored. I have nobody to play with. And you can say, I'm feeling so bored because my TV doesn't have interesting program today. Likewise, you can say, I feel bored because my best friend has left me or has gone far away. So this is how you feel bored. Okay, so you don't like to do anything. You are not interested to do things. So it is your bored feeling. Another word is, feeling word is tired. When you play a lot, how do you feel? You feel very, very tired, right? How do you know you are tired? Yes, when you feel that your hands or your legs are trying to or starting to feel, pain or, ache, something like not very strong, then you feel tired. So it is called tired feeling. So this is how you can describe someone's feeling if someone is not feeling very energetic. Another word is thirsty. So what is thirsty? Thirsty means you want to drink water. When you are walking in a hot sun or when you are running for a long time, you feel dry, right? You feel dry in your stomach or in your throat. And then you want to drink water to quench your thirst. So you can say, I am thirsty. I want some water. Would you give me some water, please? You can ask your family members or friends. Okay, another word to describe people is the appearance. What is appearance? Appearance means the look of the person. How someone looks when you see through your eyes. So feeling is something that you feel through your body. And appearance means you can find someone with your eyes. Okay, when you see someone, jab tapai kasailai dekhnuhuncha, then what you find in someone, maybe the person thin, you can say someone is thin. Thin means एकदमै पातलो हैन पातलो means thin in English so someone is not very has not very big body so thin another physical appearance you know describing word for physical appearance is short short means not very tall okay short means you know having not much height okay when someone has you know less height we can say short person okay another one is tall tall is having better height than the other okay so these are the appearance describing word now another word another type of words are personality words you can say someone calm when if someone does not speak much okay if your friends does not speak much then you can say a calm person the person has calm personality another word is moody are you moody okay moody means having changes in the mood you are happy at the same time and quickly you are angry excited you know you are not stable you are not same you change okay your mood changes so you can say moody you can change your mood or emotion quickly so you are moody then the moody personality will be there okay another word for personality is handsome if someone has all the fitness all fit body and also good appearance and all feelings everything is okay then you can say handsome okay these are the words for describing some examples okay students this is how you can describe your family members can you do this okay you can describe your grandfather you can describe your mother you can describe your uncle they all have different feelings right your brother may be very exciting and funny and your uncle may be fat or tall or he may be very handsome so this is how you can tell how someone in your family look okay so we are talking about these describing words now let's go for more we can describe people according to different ways different themes or different words for example is if someone is in different is we have different word for that if someone has many ears for example you can see here old lady and old lady middle aged young lady you can say in according to the age you can say someone is if someone is very has many years old and then you can say old person and if someone is in your father's age or has in the middle of old people and young people then they are middle aged and children like you are young people okay so this is how we can describe from the age side okay now another word another side this is middle age young age now weight according to the weight we can describe people okay if you have very big body and if you have you know much weight then you can say someone is fat and if someone is athletic or playing a lot and has good body you can say fit if someone has not good enough body or has less amount of less in comparison to the size of others if they are smaller then they can be thin okay look at there okay the person is thin look at this person and look at this person they are totally opposite right now let's look at another word or another side from another side you can describe is the height of the people Height means how tall are the people. Some people are short, some people are medium height, and some are tall. Okay, so you can say if someone is tall, then you can, they are tall. My friend is tall. You can say my family is tall. And you can say I have a friend who is very short, like that. So you can see this picture. It is tall and medium height, short. Okay, tall, medium height, short. Now let's look at from the eyes. Okay, some people have different kinds of eyes. You can have different colors of the eyes as well. Some have brown eyes, some have green eyes and blue eyes. Some people have small eyes, some people have big and wide eyes, open big wide eyes. Let's look at the face. Face and hair. Hair here, face, you can see different face and different types of hair. Let's see first face. Some face are round, okay? Like similar to circle, and some face are long. Do you have long face or round face? You can check yourself, okay, in front of a mirror, okay, students? Okay, and another type of face is oval. Oval means like this, you know, shape of an egg. Okay, another way of describing or another side of describing people are from their hair. So what kind of hair they have? Let's look at hair. You can see the girl has brown hair. Another girl, a woman, has dark and red hair and blonde. Look at this different type of hair. They have, according to the color, you can say brown, dark, red, and blonde. Blonde is a mixture of yellow, and it is like, color similar to the banana. Okay? And you can see here in the picture as well, it's shining as well. Then the other, there it is brighter than the other. Okay, now, another picture for describing hair is the spiky one. Okay, do you have a spiky hair? The spiky hair means having straight up. Okay, boys especially like to make their hair spiky. Do you have that spiky hair? Okay, some of you, yes, definitely. And many of us have curly hair. Okay, we naturally can get curly hair. Look at this, how curly hair looks. It is curvy, right? Yes, it's bent, bent and many bends. Another kind of hair is wavy. It's going like a wave of a river. Another one is straight. It's like many of you have straight hair. Straight is just going straightly down. That this is kind of different kind of hair you can describe. Now we have this exercise. Can you see in your book? Please now look at your book on page number 8. Did you open your book? Okay, my dear students, now I'd like you to see the exercise and guess the meaning of or the words here and fit here in the empty places or blanks. Here you can see hair. What kind of hair do you think? You have the choices here. You can choose. Yahanbata chhanna saknuhuncha. Tall, happy, big, slim, blonde. Okay, which kind of hair you have? Is it tall hair? No. What kind of hair did we talk? We talked about blonde hair. So, it's blonde hair. You can write here blonde. Did you guess so? Yes, you are good and smart. You are right. Now, let's fill in the blank. Next blank here, nearby the man. He is standing and how does he look? Can you see the words describing him. Okay, a slim man, tall man. Yes, he is slim and tall. Okay, another one, another picture we have in our book is about this family. What do you think? How do you describe this size of the family? Is it a small family or a big family? Yes, it's a big family. So we put here big family. Another, a girl is here. She's doing something. How does she look? Can you describe her appearance? How does she look and how does she feel? Is she sad? No, yes. She is happy, right? She is happy. So a happy girl, you can say. Okay, this is how we describe different people. Now let's do this activity from page number 8 of your book. Okay, students, are you ready? Now let's make sentences with these describing words: happy, big, and blonde. And we are also going to order the words in alphabetical order. The words are given here: tall, happy, big, slim, and blonde. Now let me first write the sentences. Please guess your sentences first. I'll give you some time and I'll give you my sentence as well. Okay, let's see how we make our sentences. Okay, dear students, now I'd like you to make sentences. Now, I'll give you some example and you can make similar sentences. Okay, from happy, let's make sentence. Let's make sentences. From number one is happy. You know what happy means? So you can say, I am happy. I am happy now. Okay, you can make your sentence like this. You can say, I am happy now. My friend is happy now. My sister is happy now. Or I'm feeling happy now. Like this, you can make your sentence. Another sentence, another word is big. Can you tell me your sentence? Okay, now let's see how you made your sentence and how I am going to make. I have a big book. I have a big book. If you have very big book, a story book with a lot of picture, then you can say, I have a big book. Or you can say, we have a big house. You can say, we have a big house. Okay, now another word is blonde. Blonde is the word for describing what? Is it describing face? No. Is it describing, appearance? No. It is a describing word for hair. Yes. Hair. So you can say, I want to. I want blonde hair. You can simply say, I want blonde hair. So this is how you made your sentence: big, happy, and blonde. Okay, likewise, you can make many more such sentences with describing word. Okay, students, now let's see another exercise. Look here. What is it saying? Put these words in alphabetical order. We have tall, happy, big, slim, blonde. Okay, we have different words like blonde. We have another word, big. We have another word, slim. Happy. And tall. How do we order them according to alphabetical order? What is alphabetical order? Can you guess? Ordering means keeping something in sensible order, after one after the other. How something comes after the other, that is the ordering things in a proper order. So here we have one rule, that is alphabetical order. Alphabet means we have alphabets like A, B, C, D, E to Z. Okay, from A, B, C, D to Z. This is called alphabetical order. So, B comes after A, C comes after B, and C comes, before D. Likewise, how some words or some letters are coming, they have the order according to alphabetical order. So this is called alphabetical order. Alphabetical order. Okay. What is alphabetical order once again? Yes. Order of alphabets or ABCD. So now let's try to see the first. You have to see the first letter of the each word. Look here. We have S, B, B, H, and T. Which one do you think is the earlier or beginning words? Beginning letter. Okay. B is coming at first, and another B is here. We will see later which B comes first. And then after B, then there is H, and then comes S, and then only T. Okay, so this is how we make order. Now we have B and B. How do we now again make which comes first? Can you decide which comes first? How to decide? Now we have to look the second letter here. Look here. We have L here, and there we have I. So you have to put I before L because I comes before L. Okay? Isn't it? Yes. L comes after I. So we put L after I. So the correct order, alphabetical order of these words is big, blonde, happy, slim, and tall. This is how we order them. Okay, students? Now, let's see opposite words to talk about different peoples. We have different describing words again here, but they are pairs of the different, opposite words. Opposite means just exactly the different words. They have different meaning. For example, you can see here flashing words. Flashing words, look at flashing words. Can you see? Happy and sad. And good and bad. Old and young. Poor and rich. Fat and thin. Difficult and easy. Short and tall. Hot and cold. So these are all opposite words. Okay? So happy and sad are the totally different words. So opposite words means different in meaning, opposite in meaning. All right, now we have these different describing words, and they have opposite meanings. Now let's understand through the pictures. Okay, students, now let's look at this picture. Can you see this picture here? There is an old man and there are young children. So old and young are opposite words. Old means you are having more ages, and young means you are just in few years. So another word is strong and weak. Strong means you can look at this picture. Strong person can lift up things easily, and weak when you have a thin body and you have no exercise, you have no good food, then you are weak and you cannot lift the things. Okay, so this is strong and weak. Another word is mean and kind. Can you see here what is the person doing to this person, another one? Okay, yes, the yellow one is doing very bad thing to others. So doing bad things like teasing, laughing at others is being mean. Okay, do you do this? Okay, it's not good, right? Okay, so another picture says it is kind thing to do. So kind means helping, saying good words is being kind. So mean and kind are opposite words. Look at these pictures. Thin is having very skinny body. You have smaller size of your body. And fat means having a lot of fat in your body. So thin person has less fat, less flesh, and fat person has a lot of fat in their body. So it is called fat. Fat and thin are the opposite words to describe people. Another one is active and lazy. Look at this. Which one you are? Are you active or you are lazy? Okay, active person is laughing, jumping, doing things regularly, and lazy person is just lying and not doing thing, sleeping a lot. Another one is tall and short. Tall means having the higher height, and short means lower height. Another one is happy and sad. It is about feeling when you are getting good things, when you are learning well in your school, you are happy. When you can't learn, when you don't achieve good marks, you are sad. So happy and sad. Dirty and clean are another opposite words. Dirty means having mud or things in your hand, and cleaning means you are cleaning the things with water and soap. So dirty and clean are also opposite words. Now, after this idea, now I want you to match the opposite words from your book. Can you look at your book on page number 11? And this is the exercise for matching the opposites. The words are old, big, happy, tall, slim, funny, and another words, pair words for opposite is the small, short, and fat, serious, young, and unhappy. Okay, can you match these words to their opposite meaning? Okay, now I think you have already finished doing this. I will now check yourself, okay? This can be old person is opposite to young, and big is opposite to small. Happy is opposite of unhappy. Tall is opposite. Tall means very high, and short means very small in height. Slim means having no fat in the body, and fat means a lot of big fatty body. And funny means doing a lot of jokes and laughing a lot. And serious means not being happy and all the time being sad and not giving good response to others. Serious, okay? So these are the words for matching opposites. Okay, now let's see the exercise that is describing people. You can describe all of the people with different such quality words. You can say some tall, you can say some short, some can be fat. Okay, I have some examples. My grandfather is old. My grandmother is kind. My father is handsome. My mother is beautiful. My uncle is strong. My aunt is smart. My sister is cute. And my brother is funny. Now you can describe all the family members with these describing words we have learned. Here in this describing word, you have old, kind, handsome, beautiful, strong, smart, cute, and funny. You can describe with other describing words, keeping replacing these words as well. You can say, my grandfather is slim. My grandfather is fat. My grandfather is very active. You can describe like this. Okay, students? Okay, students, now we have the last exercise that is your assignment as well. You are going to describe your friends now. We have described our family. And now, can you describe your friends with the describing words we have learned? We have learned opposite describing words. We have learned feeling describing word. We have learned the appearance describing word, personality describing word. You can use those words to describe your friends. Okay? Now, I have an example for you. This is, you can start your sentence like this. My friends are Rita, Sita, and Raju. Rita is tall, but Sita is short. Raju is fit, but Sita is fat. We are happy friends. Another way you can do is, you can also say, there are many friends in my class. Some are funny, but some are serious. You can now describe who are serious, who are funny, who are calm, who are tall, who are short. Likewise, you can go on describing your friends, okay? Okay, students, now this is the last exercise. We have come to the end of our today's lesson. I hope you have learned some of the describing words today. Now you can do this exercise and show it to your teacher. Thank you. Thank you for participating in this video lesson. See you tomorrow.